That's the attitude Jesus is reminding each of us today in the Gospel. Wir sind unnütze Diener. Wir haben nur unsere Verpflichtungen getan. Kami mga alipin, walang kabuluhan. Tumubad lang kami sa aming mga kumpulin. Brothers and sisters, at the end of the day, or at the end of the week, could each one easily say that, well, we have done what we were obliged to do? Have we done what we were obliged to do as our service to God? You see, it's very hard to say, because if we really look at our lives, or how much time, how much attention we have really given God, and look at the amount of time and attention that we have given to all our concerns and our needs and our activities, we could hardly see enough for if there is any at all that we have given in our service to God. But like the disciples, we could only say, Lord, increase our faith. Last Sunday, we celebrated our first Filipino saint, San Lorenzo Luis de Manila, who unconditionally said while he was being tortured to his death, if I have 1,000 lives, I will still give them all to God. And in a month, we will be celebrating All Saints Day, November 1st. All the saints are people like us. They, like us, are we, fragile sinners. But at the end of their life, they could say, we are unprofitable servants who have done only what we have obliged to do. Because they, at the end of their life, they have served God. And in a month, we will all be celebrating, the month of October, this month that we are celebrating the greatest of all saints, the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of Jesus. We call this month the month of the Holy Rosary. And this is the commemoration of the last apparition of the Blessed Virgin in Fatima, October 13th. And in that apparition, in those series of apparitions, she was always reminding us, convert to my son, Jesus. And you know, in my own Haima province, in the Philippines, in Pangasinan, today, October 6th, we are celebrating Our Lady of the Holy Rosary of Manila. So we have her statue there. And, you know, what made Mary, as I said, the greatest of all saints is because it is not at the end of her life, but even right at the beginning of her life, she was already able to say to God, to this day, as we pray the Angelus, I am the servant of the Lord. Let it be done unto me according to your word. And Mama Mary served Jesus, and even follow Jesus until the end, like Jesus under the cross, and until her life's end. So here we have the statue of Mama Mary. Last Sunday we had the statue of San Lorenzo Ruiz. You see, many of us, we also have statues of our favorite saints at home. So whenever we look at statues of saints, and we all know, we are just looking at images. But they are images, although fragile, they can be broken, of the real person behind who were saints in spite of their own humanity. You and I, each one of us, we were all created, as we always quote that from Genesis, after the image and the likeness of God. That is what the Bible tells us right at the beginning. Therefore, we are God's face here on earth as long as we they are living. And that is what sainthood is really all about. Sainthood is being the face of Jesus to other people. My favorite commentary, the Gospels, is a Bible scholar, and he said, a saint is someone whose life makes it easier to believe in God. A saint is someone who makes it easier for other people to believe in God. How do you live your life here on earth? Do you make it easier for other people to believe in God, or you make it more difficult for others to believe in God? What face do we see in you? Do we see the face of Jesus or some other face? Di ba may mga taong pag narinig na sila magsalita, parang dilan sa tanas ang narinig natin? Mga ganon. We encounter certain persons whose behavior bring us away from God. That is what our first reading is telling us. The prophet Habakkuk, he complained to God, he was really losing his faith. What kind of God are you? Lord, I cry to you, violence, but you do not intervene. There is strife and clamorous discord, but you do not listen. You see, we live in a world that is full of the face of evil, violence, and destruction. And it is worked out by people like us, and they make it difficult for others to believe in God. That is why we, Christians, on the other hand, are called to be the face of God here on earth. From creation on, long before you and I were born, we were all called to be the image of God here on earth. And from baptism on, we were called to be like His Son, Jesus, here on earth. We Christians are the face of Jesus here on earth. That is our mission. We celebrate All Saints Day because there are many like us who during their lifetime were not declared saints with capital S. They were not proclaimed as saints by the church. They are not in the list. But all the same, that's why we declare All Saints Day, even those who are not in the list, all the same, they strive to live their life, become the face of God or the face of Jesus here on earth while they live. On such unproclaimed saints, those with small S, there is an Irish American Franciscan priest, Father Michel Jones. He was assigned the sales worker for the New York Fire Department. Then, you know what is famous and notorious September 11, 2001? What happened? When terrorists flew two big airlines into the New York Trade Center. Now, Father Michel, being the chaplain of the fire department, all fire department went into the scene. He rushed from his convent and also entered the burning tower. There, he was helping firefighters, colleagues, and was also praying for the victims, for all people who are trapped there, as well as for the firefighters, praying for them. After anointing a firefighter, Father Michel was hit by falling debris and killed. Well, until now, he's not yet proclaimed a saint with a capital S, but he is popularly called the saint of 9/11. Now, I'm telling this because he has this favorite prayer that I believe that became the guide for his life. His public prayer became popular all over the world. You can easily find this, just simply Google search Bishop Jacques. And the prayer goes like this: Lord, take me where you want me to go. Let me meet who you want me to meet. Tell me what you want me to say and keep out of your way. But you know, dali mo ako, saan kung saan nais mo akong pumunta, kaya kung harapin mo ang sinong gusto mong makatagpo ko, sabihin mo sa akin kung ano ang gusto mong sasabihin ko, at ingatan mong manatili ako sa daan mo. Here, bring this Lord in who dwells the city's cave. Let me strengthen when who dwells the city's cave. Zamir was the beast as this Zamir, on alchemist of Daniel. So upon waking up, my dear brothers and sisters, tomorrow and then every day, this will be a very good morning prayer to start your day, especially before leaving home, going to your work or whatever, so that everywhere you go, whatever you do, people you meet on the way, people everywhere will see the face of God in you. You may not become a saint with capital S, but definitely a saint with small s, whose life makes it easier for other people.